thanks for tuning in with my channel. My name's Christian. I'm with Outdoor Game Cameras, and today I'm talking about this new camera. It just came out, 2023 Brownie Defender Vision Pro. I'm excited, so let's go ahead and talk more about this camera and get this camera set up. This camera is connected by Verizon. They do have one that's connected by AT&T. It has 4G LTE. Unlimited plans start at $14.99 a month. View images and videos and clips on your mobile device. You have 20 MP pictures. Adjustable trigger speed from 0, 1, 3, 5 to 0.7 seconds. Then we have GPS Theft Protect. Then we have the Radiant 4 Night Illumination Technology. You have the Night Vision IR Illumination up to 110 feet. You have 8 rapid fire shots in 2 seconds. You have heavy duty steel tree mounting bracket. Here's the seller plans and features. It says the best still unlimited pictures annually or monthly plans. So you can do this annually, like once a year, or you can do it monthly. I'm gonna do it monthly because I only have this camera mounted for 4 months. And then after the 4 months I'm done, then I'll cancel the contract. So it's pretty nice, you can do that. And it all depends on how many cameras you have too. And if you wanna do videos, upload videos too. So I'm actually gonna do the Guide Pro. It's $49.99 a month, and then it does 12,000 standard images, 400 HD images, and then 150 video uploads, up to 6 cameras. So I'm gonna do that because I get a lot of these cameras. And if you think about like gas and stuff, gas is expensive right now, so this is really not too bad. And you have the option to go to 100 plus too. It's a little less on videos and then images, but you can pick that too. And then you have Hunter, Scott Plus, or Scott. So you can really pick what one you would like to try out. And you can always change that too if you want to up your plan. And you can cancel it anytime too. So on the bottom it says it's $5 per camera additionally, and that is through from now until January 1st, 2024. So that's not a bad deal. So I'm paying $49.99 a month, and then plus $5 per camera. Let's go ahead and talk more about the seller feature list and the camera feature list. We have the seller feature list. We have built-in chipset for Verizon activation, pre-installed Verizon SIM cards. We have uploads HD images and videos, GPS tagging images, email text images, security mode uploads, images, and sends you a alert. Create unlimited folders for organization, images online, sort images by time, date, moon phase, and temperature, month-to-month data plans, easy to use mobile app for tablets and smartphones. Activate cameras only when you need them. Activate multiple cameras on the same data plan. No contracts. We have the camera feature list. Adjustable IR flash for power saver, long range, and fast motion. We have 1920 by 1080 FHD video with sound, 5 seconds to 2 minutes in length. Then we have adjustable detective range, up to 80 feet. We have GPS tagged images. We have 0.5 second recovery time between images. We have SD card management options. SMI IR video. We have long battery life from 8 AA batteries not included. Then we have battery meter functions with alkaline and lithium batteries. Up to 8 multi-shot images. Programmable picture delay, 1 second to 60 minute. Picture info bar displays, time, date, temperature, moon phase, and camera ID. We have 12 volt external power jack. Supports up to 512 gigabyte SDXC memory card, not included. We have external antenna support. So far this camera looks great, so let's go ahead and unbox this camera. What comes in the box is your camera, your instructions, and your 6-foot strap. On the side, there's a latch you pull up. This whole thing opens up. Right here displays what model this camera is. It has Brownie's customer service, their phone number, and then this is their website. Right here is a tripod mount. This is the tray. That's where the batteries go. Push the eject button and pull this right out. And then you put your batteries in and push this back in. And make sure you hear it lock. There you go. This is where your SD card goes right here. This right here is your 12 volt external power. This right here is your eject button. On and off switch mode programming buttons. E for enter. LCD screen. This is your QR code. And then this is your camera lens. These right here are your night vision IR LEDs. This is your PIR sensor right here. This is your external antenna port. And then this right here is your motion test LED. This is your light sensor, microphone. And go ahead and latch this over. Make sure you hear it lock. And then right here, this is where you put your 6 foot strap right here. And then this right here is where you put your 6 foot cable. That's not included. The one thing I really like about this camera, it has no antenna. It's just on the side, but the animals won't hurt it like the bears and elk, because they'll try to eat that off. Here's the other side. Here's the bottom. Here's the back, and here's the front. Here's a couple things you need before you set your camera up. You'll need your camera. You'll need 8 alkaline or lithium batteries. I'm using alkaline Ravac high energy batteries. I've had good luck with that brand. And then you need your SD card. This is a Cindes. This is 128 gig. I've had good luck with that brand too. So let's go ahead and put our batteries and our SD card in our camera. All right, so let's go ahead and put our batteries inside our camera. So you want to make sure you hear it lock. So this locks. There you go. Then your SD card goes right here. You want to make sure it locks too. There you go. This camera's got 3 modes. You got trail, that's non-cell reception, and then you got video, that's non-cell reception. And then you got cell reception, where you can control this through the app or your tablet or your phone. I'll walk you through those steps and how to set this camera up. So the first thing you need to do is turn off your cell reception so we can go to the trail non-cell reception. So go ahead and turn on your camera, push the mode button, and then you're gonna go up to LTE features. It's gonna say enable, you wanna disable it. So push enter, the E, then push down, and then push it again. Now your camera is on non-cell reception. So let's go down to the time and date. Let's go ahead and talk about that. Here's the date and time. So this is really important. Go ahead and push enter there. That'll start flashing. You can go up and down as you need to. And then right and left, and then up and down. Today is May 18th, 2023, and it is 11:15 a.m. So I'm going to go 15. And then after you're done there, go ahead and push enter. And then this is operation mode. You can go on trail or video. I'll walk you through all these steps on trail and video. I'll leave it on trail. Photo quality. You can change the quality of the photos. You can go from 2MP, 4MP, 8MP, 20MP. We'll leave it on 20MP. And then we'll go down. Video quality. We'll talk more about that here in a little bit. And video length. Picture delay. This applies to videos and pictures. So it's delay time between, like, say if you have 2 pictures. So your camera is not live all the time. It has to have the pause before it takes the next picture or next video. So you want to make sure that if you're in the area, your camera is taking lots of pictures and videos, you want it to be at 1 second, or you can go to 5 seconds, or 10 seconds, or 20, or 30 seconds, 1 minute, 5 minutes, 10 minutes, 30 minutes, or 60 minutes. I'm gonna leave it on 1 second because I wanna make sure I get those animals that come really quick by. Multi-shot mode, this is an important setting too. So if you push enter, it'll start flashing. You can go to 2 shots, Standard, now standard slower. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. This is rapid fire and that's faster. 2 shot, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I'm gonna leave it on 8. Temperature unit, Fahrenheit or Celsius, all depends where you live. I'll leave it on Fahrenheit. Camera name, this is important, so take your time on this. Push enter there, and then you can go up and down as you need to. And then there's a space between the Z and 0, so that's how you get a space. And then after you're done there, go ahead and push enter, and then go down to image data strip. This is important. I'm going to leave that on. That's the little strip on the bottom of the pictures and videos that has the time, date, and moon phase. And then the camera ID, that's important to leave on. Motion test, I always test it. I know this is a new camera, but I always make sure. And then push on. Then on the top left, you'll see that light come on. It means it's detecting motion, so then you're good there. Push the mode button. And then motion detection, you can change this too if you like, from 60 to 80 feet. I'll leave it on 80. Battery type, you can do alkaline batteries or rechargeable batteries or lithium. I have alkaline, so I'll leave it on alkaline. Trigger speed, you can do it on fast or normal. I'll leave it on fast. Default settings, I leave that on no. What that means is so it won't go back to the manufacturer settings. If you go to yes, it will. I want to save these settings. Smite IR video. This applies to videos. We'll talk about that here in just a little bit. SD management, I leave it off. What that means is so say if your SD card fills up with videos or pictures, it won't take any more. But if you leave it on, it'll rewrite over those pictures and videos and just take and erase and take and erase. Delete all, you can delete all the videos and pictures on the SD card. IR flash power, you can change this from long range, fast motion, and economy. We'll leave it on long range. LTE features, this is the LTE info, network status, server status, LTE test, LTE antenna, GPS test. Capture timer, this applies to videos and pictures. So you can actually have your camera come on at certain times and turn it off at a certain time. So that's pretty cool. I will leave that off. SW upgrade, I always make sure this camera is updated. Now this is a new camera, but let's just make sure, go ahead and push that. And then it'll just say the information. If there's an upgrade, it will let you know. So after that, all I gotta do is go back and push the mode button. It's on trail, here's the countdown. Here's how many pictures I have on the SD card. This is how many I can take, and that's my battery life. Look out for my next review on how to set your camera up so it'll be a non-cell reception video mode. Let me show you how you set your camera up so it'll be in video mode. This is non-cell reception. So go ahead and turn on your camera. Push the mode button. Push down. Operation mode. Go to video. And then you go to video quality. You can change this to ultra or high. I'll leave it on ultra. And then video length, you can change this to 5 seconds, 10 seconds, 20 seconds, 30 seconds, 1 minute or 2 minutes. I'm gonna leave it on 1 minute. And then picture delay, this applies to videos too. I'm gonna leave it on 1 second. So there's a delay between two videos, so there's a 1 second delay, and you can adjust that too if you like, but I want to make sure I get the best videos, and because the animals come quick, and I want to make sure that my camera is always ready. And then you go down to Smite IR video, want to make sure that's on. So it's off, we want to make sure that's on. And then SD management applies to videos too. I leave it off. Delete all, that applies to this setting too. And then you go down to capture timer. You can do that too with videos. And I'll leave that off, but you can change that if you like. then SD management, we're good there. After that, all you gotta do is push the mode button. And it's on video mode, countdown. This is how many videos it's got on the SD card. This is how many it can take on the SD card. There's my battery life. Look out for my next review on how to set your camera up so it'll be in cell reception. The next thing you need to do is turn on your cell reception. So go ahead and turn on your camera. Wait for it to boot up, push the mode button. Go up to LTE features. It's gonna be on disable. You wanna enable it, push enter. Then go down to enable. And then you have LTE info. This is your IMEI number, ICC ID number. There's mine right there. And then you got your network status, 4G. And then that's how many bars my camera is, the strength. And then you have server status. So this is how many pictures and videos you have. So I have that many pictures left and then that many videos. So that's how that works. And then LTE test. I'm gonna test this camera. Now, when you do this the first time, it's gonna take a little bit for it to find the network, so be patient. And if there's any pictures or videos on this camera, it'll upload those. LTE antenna, so what that means is internal is the one inside the actual camera. And then if you change this to external, it's the one that's outside, you can extend and have a longer antenna. That's an accessory you can buy and that's separate. GPS test, this is a cool setting. So if you push okay on that, it'll search for GPS searching. And then on the app, you can find your camera. It's really cool. So I'll show you that later, how that works. And we can talk more about that. And it says it fixed. All right, we're good to go. Now, the next thing you gotta do is go ahead and push the mode button. After you download the app, there's gonna be a home screen, and then this will pop up all your cameras, and then you have all photos, that'll be your videos and pictures, and then your account. That just talks more about the account there. We're gonna go back to home, and then on the top right, you see this little thing right here? It says add camera, so you push that. All you gotta do is scan the QR code. Go ahead and push add camera after you scan it. And then it's gonna say continue subscriptions. Great, you added a camera. Now you need to pick a plan. Now it's gonna be $5 extra a month to have this camera. So it's really not too bad. And then go ahead and push review subscription. Right here, this is the camera I just added. This is what the cameras I have. And then it says total due today is $5. So let's go ahead and push checkout now. And then you have your credit card information you put in. And then go ahead right here. It says I have received an update my payment information. Just gotta push that and then pay now. And now your camera's updated. Sometimes it takes the network and the camera to connect, so give it a little bit of time. So let's go ahead and talk more about the settings on the camera on the app. Here's the settings. You go ahead and push that. And on the top left, you'll have the name of the camera, last synced, time, date, plan, guide, pros, my plan, battery life, and signal, and then storage. Then you have camera name. You can change the name anytime. Operation mode. It's on trail cam. You can do video if you like. And then here's a temperature unit. You can leave it on Fahrenheit or Celsius, all depends where you live. SD management, I leave it off. Image data strip, I leave it on. Trigger speed, fast. Here's automatic time zone, I leave it on. And then camera last sync scheduled, you can schedule it if you like. You push that there. Now this is the time it's in the sink. You can delete them by just push the X, or you can add some too if you like. Once you're done there, go ahead and push the done button. And then right here is the thumbnail uploads. You can schedule this too if you like, or immediately. I'll do immediately and then push done. And then photo quality, you can change that, photo delay, multi-shot mode, IR flash power. This is the videos right here. Ultra video length, and then Smite IR video, I leave it on. SD storage, you can check that out, push that, it's at 5%, you can see how much storage you have, and then push done. This right here is your information, IMEI number, ICC ID number, and then carrier name right there. Right here is the restore default settings. Now if you push that, it'll go back to the manufacturer settings on this camera. And so there's one thing it says in the manual. It says to conserve battery power, your night videos are limited to the maximum time of 20 seconds regardless of the actual settings. So it doesn't matter what the setting is for the video length, it'll be maxed out to 20 seconds. So do keep that in mind. I think this camera and this app are easy to use. This camera will take less than 10 minutes to set up, so that's pretty easy. One thing I would recommend is to test this at your house before you take this to location, to the mountains or the woods, just to make sure it's working or there's motion. I go 4 hours away with my cameras and I just wanna make sure they're working, so that's one thing I do. I'm not sponsored or paid at all for this. I do this for fun. I enjoy the mountains, enjoy cameras, enjoy helping people out. So go ahead and help me out by subscribing to my channel and like my videos. Thanks for watching and look out for my next review on how this camera performs in the mountains. Small town, your town, double dutch in the park. Ice cream truck failing out of Mrs. Tess heart. Got to blow up Grants in the yard and it's March. Ain't coming down anytime soon. Got him nursing home still battling with some Dolly Parton.